to your ears. 60% of this band is also in Lifeless. Lifeless owes Timmy from Punishment $1,000 for writing some of the earlier Lifeless material. Before we start playing Moss riffs and you forget why we're here, these things happen all the time where we have to come together as a community and support our own. It's good that you're here. It's good that your money's going to where it needs to go to, but 364 days of the year pass while your generation sits on the telephone, knows everybody in the room because you like each other and want to fuck each other, but you're not social to each other, and it's going to go away because all you guys do is know each other from the internet. I didn't get on stage because I knew who Dennis was because of the internet. I knew Dennis because he was the kid from Delaware, and we were the guys from Philly, so we became friends. The same way when we came into Philadelphia, the guys from Bad Luck 13 said, "Look at you jerk-offs, calm down and we'll take you under our wing." The same way, this hardcore community will die if you don't stop being ignorant at shows by not talking to each other. You know each other's fucking names, you know each other's dogs, cats, moms, but you guys hide 30 groups surrounding this whole show and there's 200 kids. Talk to each other and you'll find that you can respect each other a lot fucking more. Some of the people in this room we used to hate, we're old, now we love each other, we're happy we're still fucking here. Respect what this is and it'll always be here. This is called Burning Souls. This is for all the people that are not here anymore. We'll be right back. for this song, because Joe was good friends with Bama 13 and was doing a movie, and we had some girl stab some bum in the face. That's how a lot of kids know this song. But what it's about is being a young jerk off with no respect for anybody and no morals and sense of fucking purpose, and to constantly get knocked on your ass and learn from mistakes and try to be a better person. I wrote it when I was 21, and it took me a long time to get a little bit better than where I'm at right now. But I just want to say I'm thankful to be in punishment. It gave me Damien the best shot, the best early 20s a kid could have. It introduced me to my fiance, and it kept me from going to jail. It kept me from going to the grave, and it made me a better person. Hardcore can do this for you if you respect it and you understand. We're the only 200 people in this whole fucking state here right now and in this whole world. We're it. This is what we're all sharing together. This isn't something you like on the internet or click play to. This is something you live, and the impact changed my life for the better. I hope it changes yours. This is Rising. Because I was a fucking idiot. I went on tour, met some of the coolest guys and bands I love forever, and it made me want to start this stupid band. We did a lot. We did it in broke down vans. We never had cool merch. We never had cool recordings. We never had a booking agent. We got ripped off by Met from Too Damn Hype like everybody from the 1990s. But it was fun. It was a life lesson. And you idiots for some reason still want to hear these songs, so we're blessed. We had a chance to do a cool record. We had some young kids in the band and some new blood. This is the shit off it. It's called Broken But Not Dead. It's for all the kids who feel like shit, feel like there's nothing. I'm 35, I felt the same way then. I feel a lot better now. You'll get fucking through it. Bang your heads, remember your friends, and let's have some fucking fun. Here 15 years from now. This is 1,000 Daggers.